Prostate cancer is a huge problem in the United States, roughly 200,000 new cases every year. But unfortunately, unlike for breast cancer, for instance, for prostate cancer, there is no image-based screening modality. The only real screening for prostate cancer that takes place is based on a blood serum, that is prostate-specific antigen. So if the level of PSA is high, then a biopsy is recommended. And the way the biopsy is done is essentially a blinded sextant procedure. So the urologist goes in with a needle and essentially tries to sample different parts of the prostate. And the hope is that by sampling different locations in the prostate, if cancer is present, that's going to be picked up. Turns out about 1 million biopsies are performed every year in the United States, and you know the hit rate is only about 20 to 25% for people with elevated PSA levels. So that means one of two things. One is that the specificity of PSA is not very good, or B, that this blinded procedure in going in and sampling different parts of the prostate is clearly missing a lot of cancers. Prostate cancer often gets picked up on repeat biopsies. So people come back, again they're sampled, and because this is random, maybe the next time around it's picked up. But again, 6 months have elapsed, and if it's an aggressive disease, then they're further down the disease process and makes it more difficult to treat, and the prognosis is worse. Our efforts have really been on trying to complement the current clinical protocol with using high-resolution multifunctional MRI as well as computer-aided diagnosis, so image analysis and pattern recognition tools, to really provide the clinician with high-probability regions in the image of where cancer might be present. We've been looking at the use of multifunctional MRI in conjunction with these image analysis machine learning tools that we've been developing. And the idea is first to train a pattern recognition system as to what the signature of cancer is. We've been looking at radical prostatectomy specimens, so patients who had cancer confirmed on biopsy. Physical removal of the prostate was recommended. They had an MRI done before the prostate was removed. The prostate then came out. And once it came out, on the histopathology, a pathologist was able to delineate where the cancer was. I have a student and a postdoc who have been developing methods on image registration, that is alignment of the histopathology and the MRI. So the image of the prostate taken inside the body and the histopathology after it comes out. And by developing these image alignment, image registration tools, we can now map the spatial extent of cancer from the histopathology onto the MRI. What that allows us to do now is to look at the MRI and specifically delineate locations that are cancerous on the MRI. Essentially, it's a suite of mathematical algorithms, computational algorithms, that allows us to first do the mathematical mapping from the histopathology onto the MRI to determine the extent, use that extent to train a pattern recognition tool to learn these signatures. And once we do that, now we can go into a new study, a new patient study, who has an MRI done, and essentially look for those signatures that we learned during the training process. And once the algorithm is able to identify those signatures, then that's what a clinician could use to go in and do the directed biopsy. Essentially, we've started to show on limited cohorts of data that these methods work, they work efficaciously. And I see over the next 2 to 3 years, we're going to be starting to send out proposals to start to do these clinical trials. The ability to quantitatively fuse that information is going to be huge. And we already are showing, our group and other groups are showing that this fusion is possible. And that is absolutely going to be the way to go going forward. I think this is all really, really exciting.